Hello and welcome to TranslatorsCafe.com channel. In this video, we will talk about pressure. We will discuss the unit for measuring pressure. Also, we will talk about atmospheric pressure and how it is used in everyday life and in technology. We will also talk about pressure inside our body and in space travel. We will also talk about the role of pressure in the formation of hydrocarbons and diamonds. Finally, we will discuss some interesting applications of pressure. Pressure is defined as force per unit of area. If the same force is applied to two areas, a smaller and a larger one, the pressure would be greater for the smaller area. I'm sure you will agree that it is less scary to be stepped on by someone wearing running shoes than by someone wearing stilettos. We can also demonstrate this principle in action when using a knife. If we try pushing a sharp knife down through a carrot or a tomato, we will cut it. The area where the force is applied is small, so the pressure is high enough to cut through the carrot. Now let's try to use roughly the same force, but with a blunt end of the knife. You can see that we cannot cut through the carrot because the area is greater and the pressure is lower as a result. Pressure is everywhere, and we use it in everyday life, in the industry, and in technology. Let's take this spray bottle, for example. The paint inside it is under pressure, and this is why it is sprayed out when we press the dispenser button. Now, let's look at a simple experiment with using atmospheric pressure. Let's pour some water into a glass and cover it with a piece of cardboard. While carefully holding the cardboard against the rim of the glass, let's turn it upside down. Now, let's carefully release the cardboard. As you can see, it stays in place even though we're not holding it, and the water does not escape the glass. This is due to the atmospheric pressure acting upon the cardboard. We can also conduct this experiment using a sheet of paper instead of the cardboard. The SI unit for pressure is the pascal, which is Newton per square meter. In some cases, pressure of gases is measured as the difference between the total or absolute pressure and the atmospheric pressure. This is known as gauge pressure, and it is the pressure measured when determining the air pressure in car tires. Measuring devices often show gauge pressure, although absolute pressure sensors are also in use. Atmospheric or air pressure is the pressure of air in a given environment. It usually refers to the weight of the column of atmospheric air above the unit surface area. Atmospheric pressure affects weather and temperature. Considerable changes in atmospheric pressure cause discomfort for people and animals. Decrease in atmospheric pressure can cause psychological and physical discomfort, or even death. For this reason, airplane cabins, which would otherwise experience low air pressure at cruising heights, are artificially pressurized. Atmospheric pressure decreases with the increase in altitude. People and animals who live at high altitudes, for example in the Himalayas, adapt to the low pressure. Travelers, on the other hand, often need to take precautionary measures to avoid discomfort. Some people, such as mountaineers, are affected by altitude sickness caused by the oxygen deficiency in the blood. This condition can become chronic with prolonged exposure. In severe cases, people may have life-threatening symptoms and be affected by high-altitude cerebral or pulmonary edema. Risk of severe altitude sickness typically increases at altitudes about 2,400 meters. To prevent altitude-related health problems, medical professionals recommend avoiding depressants such as alcohol and sleeping pills, to hydrate well, and to ascend to higher altitudes at a slow pace, for example on foot, instead of using transportation. Additional recommendations include diet high in carbohydrates, and also resting well, especially for individuals who ascended quickly. This will allow the body to combat the oxygen shortage, which results from low atmospheric pressure. Following the recommendations that I mentioned will help your body to produce more red blood cells that will carry oxygen to the brain and to internal organs. Your heart and respiratory rates will also increase, among other adaptations. Emergency treatment for severe altitude sickness has to be provided immediately. It is paramount to bring the patient to lower altitudes where the pressure is higher, preferably to the altitude below 2,400 meters above the sea level. Treatment also includes medication and use of the Gamow bag. The Gamow bag is a portable, lightweight container that can be pressurized by using a foot pump. The patient is put inside the bag to simulate lower altitudes. This is an emergency treatment, and simply using the Gamow bag is not enough. The patient still needs to be transported to lower altitudes. Astronauts and pilots who have to work at high altitudes use pressure suits to compensate for the low air pressure. Full pressure suits are used in space. They protect the entire body of the astronaut from the low pressure in the environment. Partial pressure suits provide counter pressure and assist with breathing at high altitude. They are used by pilots. Hydrostatic pressure is the pressure of fluid caused by the force of gravity. It is an important factor not only in engineering and physics, but also in medicine. For example, blood pressure is the hydrostatic pressure of blood on the blood vessel walls. It usually refers to arterial pressure. It is represented by two numbers, systolic or maximum pressure and diastolic or minimum pressure during a heartbeat. The instrument used to measure blood pressure is called a sphygmomanometer. Millimeters of mercury are used as units for blood pressure measurements, even in countries like the USA and the UK, where inches are used for measuring length. A Pythagorean cup is an interesting device which uses the principles of hydrostatic pressure. According to legend, it was designed by Pythagoras to moderate wine drinking. Other sources mention that this cup was meant to regulate the drinking of water during a drought. It usually has a stem and always has a dome inside of it, which allows liquid to enter from the bottom through the embedded pipe. This pipe runs from the bottom of the stem of the cup to the top of the dome, then it bends and opens into the cup. Liquid enters the pipe through this opening. The other side of the pipe that runs through the stem also has an opening at the bottom of the stem. The design and operating principles of a Pythagorean cup are similar to the ones in modern toilet bowls. If the liquid that fills the cup is above the top of the pipe, then it spills through the bottom of the cup due to hydrostatic pressure. If the liquid is below that level, one can use the cup in a conventional way. Pressure is a critical element in geology. Formation of gemstones requires pressure, both for the natural and for the laboratory-made synthetic gemstones. Crude oil and gas are also formed by intense pressure and heat from remnants of plants and animals. In contrast to gemstones, which mostly form in rock formations, oil is generally formed in the beds of water, such as in rivers and seas. There, organic material is covered with sand and silt, which gradually accumulates above it. The weight of the sand and water above exert pressure. With time, these materials are buried deeper and deeper and reach several kilometers below the surface of the Earth. Because the temperature increases by about 25 degrees Celsius per each kilometer below the surface, it reaches about 50 to 80 degrees Celsius at these depths. Depending on the total temperature and temperature fluctuation, gas may be created instead of oil. The process of gemstone formation varies, but often pressure is an important factor. Diamonds, for example, are created in the mantle of the Earth in the condition of intense pressure and temperature. They then emerge on or near the surface during volcanic eruptions, when magma carries them up. Some diamonds come to Earth inside meteorites, and scientists speculate that their formation on other planets is similar to Earth. Synthetic gemstone industry on the industrial scale started in the 1950s, and it is currently expanding. Some consumers still prefer mined gemstones, but there's a shift in consumer preferences, especially because of the many problems with gemstone mining that came to light recently. One of the methods used for growing diamonds in the laboratory is the high-pressure, high-temperature method, also known as HPHT. In this method, carbon is subjected to high temperature over 1000 degrees Celsius and pressure of about 5 gigapascals. Generally, diamond seeds are used as a base and graphite is a high-purity carbon source from which the new diamond grows. This method is common, especially for making gemstones, because it is cheap compared to the alternative methods. These laboratory-grown diamonds have similar and sometimes superior properties to naturally formed diamonds, depending on the manufacturing method. Unlike natural diamonds, which are more commonly clear, man-made diamonds are often colored. Diamonds are widely used for industrial purposes due to their properties, especially hardness. Optical qualities, as well as heat conductivity and resistance to alkalis and acids, are also valued. Cutting tools use diamond coating, and diamond powder is included in abrasive materials. Currently, a large portion of industrial diamonds is made in the laboratories, because synthetic production is cheaper than mining, and also because the demand for industrial diamonds cannot be met through mining exclusively. The high-pressure, high-temperature process is mainly used when working with synthetic diamonds. However, it is now also used on natural diamonds to enhance or adjust their color properties. Presses of different design can be used in the process. Cubic-type presses are the most expensive and complicated. They're mainly used for enhancing or changing colors in the natural diamonds. The growth within the capsule of the press is about 0.5 carats of rough diamond per day. Thank you for watching. If you liked this video, please don't forget to subscribe to our channel.